Hello students, a very fresh and beautiful morning to all. I hope you all are in good health and taking great care of yourself. Welcome back to our English class. So students, we have already completed our Unit 6, Section 1 and 2 and I have already sent you the worksheet also along with it. So today we would be seeing the last section of this textbook. Okay, so this is the last poem from your course book. The name of the poem is Colonel Fazakerley Butterworth Toast. And this poem is written by Charles Causley. Charles Causley was a Cornish writer and poet, and his poetry include many references to Cornish legends and folklore. So students, this poem is a very humorous poem, a funny poem, and it describes the failure of a ghost to frighten Colonel Fazakerley in his new castle that he had newly bought. As the colonel is about to dine, the ghost makes its appearance from the chimney and tries to scare him. So this is a very funny poem about the ghost who keeps on trying to scare away the new owner of the castle. Just like we studied in the chapter Canterville Ghost, the same way here also we have one ghost who is trying to scare away the owner, but that is not possible because Fazakerley is not at all afraid of ghost. In fact, he enjoys his company and asks him to come back again. So let's read the poem. It's very funny and you all would be enjoying it. So students, let's recite the poem. You can also recite along with it.
Colonel Fazakerley Butterworth Toast by Charles Causley. Colonel Fazakerley Butterworth Toast bought an old castle complete with a ghost. But someone or other forgot to declare to Colonel Fazak that the spectre was there. On the very first evening, while waiting to dine, the colonel was taking a fine sherry wine. When the ghost, with a furious flash and a flare, shot out of the chimney and shivered, "Beware!" Colonel Fazakerley put down his glass and said, "My dear fellow, that's really first class. I just can't conceive how you do it at all. I imagine you're going to a fancy dress ball." At this, the dread ghost made a withering cry. Said the colonel, his monocle firm in his eye, "Now just how you do it, I wish I could think. Do sit down and tell me, and please have a drink." The ghost in his phosphorus cloak gave a roar, and floated about between ceiling and floor. He walked through a wall and returned through a pane, and backed up the chimney and came down again. Said the colonel, with laughter, "I'm feeling quite weak," as trickles of merriment ran down his cheek. "My housewarming party, I hope you won't spurn. You must say you'll come, and you'll give us a turn." At this, the poor spectre, quite out of his wits, proceeded to shake himself almost to bits. He rattled his chains, and he clattered his bones, and he filled the whole castle with mumbles and moans. But Colonel Fazakerley, just as before, was simply delighted and called out, "Encore!" At which the ghost vanished, his efforts in vain, and never was seen at the castle again. "Oh dear, what a pity," said Colonel Fazak. "I don't know his name, so I can't call him back." And then with a smile that was hard to define, Colonel Fazakerley went into dine.
So students, I hope that you enjoyed reciting this poem. So now let's move on towards the explanation. This poem is quite funny and let's start the poem. Colonel Fazakerley Butterworth Toast bought an old castle complete with a ghost. So there is a colonel named Fazakerley who bought an old castle. Okay, that means usne kharida ek castle along with a ghost. That means the castle already had a ghost inside. But someone or other forgot to declare to Colonel Fazak that the spectre was there. So at the time of buying, right, when he bought that castle, at that time nobody informed him, or might be they forgot to declare that the house is haunted, the castle is haunted with a ghost. Here the meaning of spectre is ghost. On the very first evening, while waiting to dine, the colonel was taking a fine sherry wine, when the ghost, with a furious flash and a fear, shot out of the chimney and shivered, "Beware." So on the very first evening, after he bought and after he moved into the castle, it was the first evening while he was waiting to dine. That means he was about to have dinner. And at that moment, before having dinner, the colonel was taking a fine sherry wine. Sherry wine is a fortified wine which is made up of white grapes. Okay. And when the ghost, with a furious flash and a flare, shot out of the chimney and shivered, "Beware." So when he was about to take the wine, at that moment itself a ghost appeared and he was very angry. Okay, so he came with a flash and a flare. And from where did he came out? He came out of from the chimney. Chimney is there in foreign countries. Normally the houses have chimney because they have fireplaces in the house due to cold, and that smoke directly goes out from the chimney, which is outside the house. So the ghost appeared from the chimney and it started frightening Colonel Ghost. That means he tried to scare Colonel by saying, "Beware, I am already here and this castle belongs to me." Colonel Fazakerley put down his glass and said, "My dear fellow, that's really first class. I just can't conceive how you do it at all. I imagine you are going to a fancy dress ball." So Colonel Fazakerley, who was about to have wine, he kept down his glass because suddenly the ghost appeared, and he said that he is quite happy and he is quite delighted by the way the ghost entered, and that's why he said that your entry is first class. But I can't conceive how you do it at all. That means I'm not able to imagine how you started, right? Conceive means, over here the meaning of conceive means to start something, to start a project kind of thing, right? So he is not able to find it out that how did the ghost begin his journey and how did he end up in the chimney, right? And he made fun of him by saying that, "I think you are going for a fancy dress ball. I think that you are going for fancy dress ball means kind of party, okay? And there everybody is going to be dressed up in a fancy cloth. And that's why this person is wearing a white bedsheet and also is having some rattled chains in his hand so that he has a look like a ghost." At this, the dread ghost made a withering cry. Said the colonel, his monocle firm in his eye, "Now just how you do it, I wish I could think. Do sit down and tell me, and please have a drink." So when the colonel started making fun of the ghost became very angry, and at this the dread ghost made a withering cry. Withering means scornful. You can say he was so angry and his temperament got so high and he looked very dreadful. He looked very fearful. That means someone who can see that, they might get frightened. So he was very frightened and he started moaning, you can say, or he was very angry and that's why he might be shouting. And that's when the colonel said, his monocle firm in his eye. Over here, the person is wearing a glass on one of his eyes, right? So that's why it is called monocaul. If you see the meaning over here, monocaul means eyeglass. That means he is wearing something of this kind on his eye. That is called monocaul. Just like we wear specs, right, when we are not able to read clearly. In the same way, in that time, in olden times, people used to wear that one glass if they have a problem with one eye. Okay. So, his monocaul was firm on his eye. That means he was not at all scared of that ghost. And he said to him that now just how you do it, I wish I could think. That means the way you are trying to threaten me, the way you are crying, right? The way you are getting angry, the way you came inside. I don't understand, but I wish I could think. But do sit down and tell me, and please have a drink. Why don't you do one thing? Just take a seat and make me understand that how do you do all these things. And please have a drink. Aur unhone usko drink bhi offer ki. The ghost in his phosphorus cloak gave a roar and floated about between the ceiling and floor. He walked through a wall and returned through a pane and backed up the chimney and came down again. So, the ghost was in his phosphorus cloak. Phosphorus cloak means it means that it could be a white overgarment, or you can say the cloth which is quite loose. Okay, apni size se zyada badi size ke jo kapde hote hain usko cloak kehte hain. Theek hai, it looked like he was dressed in a white cloak, and he gave a roar. That means he shouted loud, just like a lion. And what did it do? It floated about between ceiling and floor. That means he tried to show the colonel that I am not a human being, or I am not a person. I am a ghost. I am a free soul, right? And that's why I can do whatever I want to. And that's the reason he just floated between the ceiling and floor. Ceiling or floor ke beech mein wo ghoom raha tha hawa mein. He walked through a wall and returned through a pain. He walked through the wall. That means he went over through the wall. Matlab war ke aar paar chala gaya. Agar koi human being hota to wo nahi kar paata, right? Lekin wo kar raha tha. And returned through the pain. Aur kahan se wapas aaya? He went outside the castle through a wall, and then he came inside the castle through a window pane. That means window ka jo glass hota hai, wahan se wo wapas aaya. And backed up the chimney and came down again. And then he again went outside the house, up at the chimney, and then again came down from the fireplace, right? So that is just to show the colonel that I am a ghost and you need to be scared of me. And why he was scaring? Because he wanted him to leave the castle and go away. But colonel didn't show any signs of being frightened. Said the colonel with laughter, I am feeling quite weak, as trickles of merriment ran down his cheek. My housewarming party, I hope you won't spurn. You must say you will come and you will give us a turn. So when the ghost was showing all different kind of stunts, the colonel said with laughter that he is feeling quite weak. He was laughing at him and he said, well, you can do so many stunts and in front of you I am quite weak. That means I won't be able to do these many things. And he kept on laughing as the trickles of merriment ran down his cheeks. That means jo khushi ke aansu honge, you can say, or you can say the laugh that wasn't stopping it was coming down, and you can make it out from his cheeks jahan par uski hansi ruk nahi rahi thi. Okay, so he was laughing out loud. And what did he say? That my housewarming party, I hope you won't spurn. Spurn means reject. That means I invite you for my housewarming party. Housewarming means when you buy a house and you throw a party for that, for buying a new house, to celebrate that, that is called housewarming party. Okay, so housewarming party ke liye usne ghost ko invite kiya ke please do come, do not reject my invitation, and you must say you will come and you will give us a turn. That means please do come, don't say no, you have to. And at that moment we would be showing you tricks. Jaise tum humko dikha rahe ho abhi tricks, waise hi hum tumko tricks dikhayenge. So please do not reject my invitation and do come to my party. At this, the poor specter, quite out of his wits, proceed to shake himself almost to bits. He rattled his chains and he clattered his bones, and he filled the whole castle with mumbles and moans. So, poor spectre who tried everything, the poor ghost who tried everything to scare the ghost, was out of his wits. That means the ghost was out of all his tricks. That means uski jo capacity thi keep on doing the tricks of making the colonel frightened, right? Nothing was working out and he was totally out of all his tricks. So at last he did one last thing which was remaining. What did he do? He proceeded to shake himself. He proceeded, that means he moved ahead and he shaked himself almost to bits. That means उसके छोटे छोटे टुकड़े हो जाए तब तक उसने प्रोसीड किया, मतलब उसने अपने आप को शेक किया. इट डजेंट मीन कि उसके टुकड़े हो गए, ठीक है. ही इट इज़ जस्ट सेइंग दैट ही शुक हिमसेल्फ सो हार्ड, ऐसा लग रहा था कि उसके टुकड़े हो जाएंगे, ठीक है. सो ही प्रोसीडेड टू शेक हिमसेल्फ एंड वॉट एल्स ही डिड, ही रैटल्ड हिज चेन्स. उसने जो चेन्स पहनी हुई थी राइट हाथ में, यहाँ पे दिखाई हुई है, इफ यू सी दिस दिस वन. सो ही रैटल्ड एंड ट्राइड टू मेक लॉट ऑफ नॉइज आउट ऑफ इट एंड ही क्लैटर्ड हिज बोन्स. ऑलमोस्ट अभी घोस्ट है तो ऑब्वियसली सिर्फ स्केलेटन ही बचा होगा, राइट. तो उसके बोन्स से उसने आवाज़ करने का ट्राई किया. ही रैटल्ड एंड क्लैटर्ड एंड ही फिल्ड द होल कैसल विथ मम्बल्स एंड मोन्स. एंड ही फिल्ड, दैट मीन्स अलग अलग डरावने आवाज़ें निकाल के, जैसे कि मम्बल्स मीन्स ट्राइंग टू से समथिंग बट इन सच अ वे दैट वी आर नॉट एबल टू अंडरस्टैंड. एंड मून मीन्स अ लॉन्ग लो साउंड मेड बाय अ पर्सन हु इज़ इन पेन, राइट. सो ही स्टार्टेड फिलिंग द होल कैसल विद दोज काइंड ऑफ साउंड विच मेक्स अस फ्राइटन, विच आर क्वाइट स्कैरी. एंड ही डिड एवरी थिंग दैट वॉज रिमेनिंग टू स्केयर colonel and make him run away from the castle. But Colonel Fazer Curly, just as before, was simply delighted and called out encore, at which the ghost vanished his efforts in vain and never was seen at the castle again. So after all these things, after witnessing the ghost who did so many things to frighten him, right, before also he did many things, jaise ki ceiling aur floor ke beech mein float karna, going through a wall and coming through a pane, and coming from a chimney and landing out of the fireplace, right. He did many things to scare ghost, scare colonel, but at that time also colonel was laughing at him. And when he did these many things, right, usne apne aap ko shake kiya, he rattled the chains and made different noises, and he also kept on crying in pain, but colonel was not at all afraid, and just like before he was simply delighted. That means he was happy to watch him doing all those things. And what did he say? Encore. Encore means repeat once more. That means he is asking the ghost to do those tricks one more time. That was the fun, and that was a kind of insult to ghost, right. Ghost ke liye insult hi hai ki uske itne darane se bhi koi insaan nahi dar raha hai. So that was quite insulting for ghost, and that's why the ghost vanished. Vanished means disappear. Because all his efforts were in vain. That means of no use. His efforts were in no use. Colonel was not at all afraid, and that's why the ghost vanished. That means he disappeared and he was never seen at the castle again. मतलब उसको दूसरी बार कैसल में देखा ही नहीं गया. He just went away from there because the owner of the castle was not scared of him. So what did Fazak said? Oh dear, what a pity, said Colonel Fazak. I don't know his name, so I can't call him back. And then with a smile that was hard to define, Colonel Fazakerly went in to dine. So Colonel Fazakerly said, what a pity. That means it's very bad that I don't even know his name. Agar mujhe naam pata hota, I would have called him back. Right? Agar naam pata hota, to usko bulate wapis. But that was not possible. And then with a smile that was hard to define. That means he was very happy, very contented, because somewhere in his mind he knew that the ghost was real and he didn't give it up over there. He didn't surrender, right? By making fun of him, he made the ghost run away from that castle. And so with a happy mind and a contented mind, he went in to dine and then he started his dinner. So students, I hope that you enjoyed this poem. It's very nice. It's very humorous. If you don't understand anything, please let me know in the live class. Thank you.